another episode of SwillinGrog's Wonderful World of Beer. This time around, I'll be reviewing Faxe, premium Danish lager, 5% alcohol by volume, brewed and canned by Royal Unibrew in Denmark. Now, what more can I tell you about Faxe premium Danish lager, apart from the fact that it comes in this huge 1-litre can? Well, I got it about 2 months ago from First Choice Liquor, and it's been sitting in the fridge ever since then. So I think it's high time that I reviewed it. Okay, let me crack this lovely can open. Alright, and I'll pour it out into this 1 litre stein, which I have not used for a very long time. Okay. It's probably going to take a while to pour this. Okay. Okay, getting a lot of head there. Let's make an assessment of the appearance, shall we? Okay, well, the appearance is a very clear golden yellow colour with a tremendous amount of carbonation there. Hopefully the camera is capturing that. And a tremendous amount of soapy white head. Four fingers, or more than four fingers, in fact. Let me just top it up a little. There's just a little bit more left in the can here. Okay, alright, well, on to the aroma. Well, what I'm picking up is a faint smell of, sweet grains. And there's some grassy sort of, aroma there too. But all in all, it's quite faint. Anyway, time for the taste test, the most important part of the review. Cheers to you all. Well, up front, it's very sweet and malty, as to be expected. There's, some, breadiness there too, to the malts, which I, enjoy. It's very crisp, very clean, and also it finishes very dry. There are some hops present there. My first impression is, it's pretty good. I mean, it's, nothing outstanding, but, definitely a good thirst quencher and, obviously, probably a good session beer too, but, before I continue rambling, I must have another gulp. Alright, well, it's certainly holding that taste profile. It's definitely a very drinkable, very sessionable lager. I am tasting a little bit of, sourness, that sort of lingers in the palate, afterwards. That's, kind of typical of these, macro, Euro lagers. It's not really, in any way offensive. What would I give it in terms of a score out of 10? Well, I do need to have another gulp. Alright, well, it's not too bad, but like I said, it's nothing outstanding or mind-blowing. It's worth checking out. If you collect beer cans, then this is certainly going to be a great addition to your collection. Anyhow, a score out of 10. I'd probably be inclined to give this 7.5 out of 10. I think that's a pretty fair assessment of it. Anyway, that does bring us to the end of yet another SwillinGrog beer review. So, until next time, fare thee well, all.